Hello everyone, it's Cindy from cindyscreativejourney.blogspot.com. Today, I'm going to be showing you how I made this cute little hanger. It's the same type of hanger that I made earlier with the poinsettia on it. So once again, I started with chipboard. They're cut 3.5 by 6. I found my mat today. And I am going to change my tips. Maybe. There we go. So that I can punch the holes in my chipboard. All right. See, it works much better if you have your cutting mat under you. And then I'm going to mark. And mark again. Okay. Down. Third one. You can do this with just one piece of chipboard. I just like the weight of three of them glued together. I also thought about, instead of putting the hanger on it, if you had a small dowel rod, you could put that between two of them and you could use it as a plant stake. For like a pot of mums, if you're giving a gift as a hostess gift. All right. Okay, so that's ready for another step. Then once again, I used my Journey Craft glue and glued it together. Making sure I match up my holes good. Okay. A little goes a long way with this. Okay. All right. And then I take my gesso again, so I'm priming my chipboard. And this is, like I said, just your primer, so you don't, it doesn't have to be smooth, it doesn't have to be in the same direction, and it doesn't have to be a very thick coat. Because all you're doing is putting a primer onto your chipboard so it doesn't soak up all your paints and inks. Okay. Because it is such a thin coat. And it's finally turned cool enough here for me to have the heater on in Maryland. It seems to be drying fairly fast. So I might not even have to hit it with the heat gun. How lucky could we be? All right, almost finished here. Okay. I'm gonna hit these ends. Close up my gesso. Wipe my brush off. Okay. And it's still a little tacky, so for the sake of time, I'm gonna zap it with my heat gun here. Once again, I'm going to be using the Oatmeal Cookie acrylic paint by Fun Stamper's Journey. Okay, I'm going to squeeze some out there and just use that as my palette. I'm going to baby wipe and get a little bit more of that off of there. Okay. And since we're mimicking wood on this one, I'm going to try to run along the grain of the so-called wood so that you get some brush strokes that mimic wood a little bit. All right. I'm going to do the edge. I'll do this edge. And then I'm going to have to heat this up a little bit. And dry it some. Do the back side same way. Get the edges also. It doesn't have to be real thick, just enough to cover the gesso because we add layers on it. Alright. Look, I didn't cut very straight on this one. Alright. I'll clean my brush out and then I'm going to wrap it in a baby wipe until I can go clean it up. Alright. And then I'm going to zap it again. Painted over my holes here. So I use my scissors. Alright, then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take our Canvas Prints, which is stamp set 0019. It's a background stamp. It's one of the original ones from Fun Stamper's Journey. And this one has the indexing on the back. Some of them don't yet. If they're still part of the old batch, not all of them have indexing. But I'm not putting it on a block. I'm just using it like this. And all I'm doing is adding some texture to my back. So it kind of mimics wood on the back too, if anybody looks at the back of your hanger, or if you were using it as a plant stake. Okay, and then I'm just going to do the edges here because we cover most of it up. to the side and clean it up later. All right, then the next thing I did was I took one of my sponges and I, once again, distressed the edge of my wood piece to make it look old, give it a little bit of depth, just adding layers to it. Okay, and then I did my edges here. Okay, and then, so that's the back of your piece and it's done. And I flip it over and I kind of do the same to the front. Not very neat or precise, it's just putting an edge on it. Okay, next I'm going to switch to pumpkin bread ink. That first one was hazelnut blend. Okay, and then I'm using it directly to the chipboard along the edges. Okay, just like that. And this is on the front part of the piece. All right, and then I did so where it shows through a little bit and I want it to look like wood, I used just this sharp edge. See how I did that to make it kind of look like a wood grain, like a paneling? And I went back with the hazelnut and did the same thing right along that same line. It doesn't show much, but it just kind of shows through. So it's your faux wood grain on your chipboard piece. And then I set this aside and I grabbed a piece of the wood grain paper, and it comes from the Bible journaling pack again. And what I did was, I think it's called Faith Journal. I ripped it towards me again. Okay. And it is already wood grained, but I'm gonna enhance that some. Alright. Pull out my piece. Alright, I can tear some more off up here. Okay. Then I used my hazelnut blend again and did my edges direct to paper. Once again, I took my pumpkin bread and I enhanced the wood grain that's on there. All right, and went back right along those with the edge. Of the hazelnut blend. Just do a light darkening. I'll put some, not knots, but okay. All right. After I did that, I took my craft glue and I glued it down again. Wasn't to me, there's not enough difference here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back with my pumpkin bread and add some more pumpkin bread to the edge of the chipboard so that it looks like a different color of wood. And I'm also going to take my hazelnut blend and darken up the edges here. Okay. Alright, then I have a piece of chipboard, and it was cut 1 3/4 by 2 1/4, and I'm going to glue a piece of the hazelnut blend cardstock to it. Okay. Trim it down a little bit. And I'm going to take my hole punch and I'm going to go over here to the corners. I'm just eyeballing it. Okay, I didn't punch all the way through because these mini brads are really, really mini. And this way they'll just stay in better. And they come gold and silver. Oh, that's a silver one. There's a gold one. I believe that's a gold one. Is that gold? Nope, that's silver. There, that's gold. I'll put those up. Don't drop those. They're hard to clean up. Speaking from experience there. Put that back in there. And then, I'm just going to hook these through. Spread the legs on the back so they don't go through. All right. Oh, look, I got a silver one. Put that aside for later. All right. Then I used my hazelnut ink. Just kind of darken the edges there a little bit. And once again, I'm gonna, this doesn't always show up real well. get some wood grain. All right. And then I'm going to glue this down. And it's time to start stamping it. Having a little bit of fun here. Okay. So that's glued down. All right. Next, I'm using the Give Thanks set. It's stamp set 0041, and we're using the Count Your Blessings and this oak leaf here on it. So I have my Count My Blessings. And this is one of the stamps that's not indexed. And I ink it up with the hazelnut ink. It's going to be upside down, but that's all right. Okay. So then I went and die cut it. I already have it die cut. That's what I like about these, because it comes with a matching set of dies. And the first thing I did is I took my hazelnut blend and my sponge and I inked my edges. Okay, and that gives it one more layer of dimension there. And I took my gold pan pastels and my sponge here, and I just kind of lightly gave it a shimmer. It's a very light touch, but it adds a little shimmer to your sign there. All right, so that piece is done. Then I'm going to take another scrap of pineapple smoothie and the oak leaf here, and I'm going to stamp two oak leaves with pumpkin bread. All right. And then I have my raspberry berry. Okay. I'm going to stamp one there. All right. And then those get die cut. So I have one, two, and three. Okay. And I'm finished with that stamp set. Then the next stamp set that I used on this was the Autumn Days. Aren't those gorgeous leaves? And it too has a matching die. So I have another piece of pineapple smoothie here, and I used my pumpkin bread ink pad again, stamped two. Well, that one I'd only get one, but let me show you what I did with them. I have my pan pastels, and this set is the Rich Sorbet set, and it has the the pumpkin bread in it. So what I did was I took my small tool that comes when you buy this set of pan pastels, and I just outlined it like this. And it's okay if it gets on the tips of those leaves, because it ends up giving it more depth. But this way, then it's not such a stark, well, here's where my stamped image is, and here's where my die cut was. All right, so I did that on both of them. Put these up. All right. And here's the two die cuts. All right. And then the next thing I stamped was the oak leaf with the raspberry berry ink onto some pumpkin bread. And I took a sponge and did the same thing around the outside of it. Okay. So I went all the way around it, die cut it, and here's that leaf. So now that all the embellishments are stamped and die cut, then we can start working on them to put the rest of the project together. All right, so we already ended up inking this edge. We put the gold pan pastel on it. I'm going to end up putting two pop dots on the back. Just laying it out here. All right. And I used one of the pumpkin bread ones and one of the raspberry berries. I ended up inking the edges just like that. All right. Then I took my bone folder and I just kind of curled my leaf a little. All right. Same thing with this one. I curled my leaf. And I used glue. And glued it down in this corner. All right. You're just gluing just the tip of it here. All right. Then I'm going to glue that one there. Spread them out a little. Next, I took my another gold element, and I didn't really want the gold, so what I did was I took my raspberry and I kind of inked it up. I don't know if you can see what I'm doing here. With my raspberry berry ink. All right. Oh, and my white liner tape is. And I twisted them together. Once this ink dries, it's permanent, but I touched it and it wasn't quite dry yet. So. Okay, my white liner tape is in a basket for class today. So I have a small piece of a different brand here that's thinner. And I figured out just where I wanted them and taped them down. Okay, my fingers are all gooped up. All right. And I peeled off the backs of my pop dots. And placed it over that. All right. So then the next thing I did was start working on my bigger leaves. Okay. So I ink the edges again. on all of them. Just like that. Okay. Love those rich fall colors. All right. Then I used my edge of my sponge and added a little bit of depth in the center of them. Okay. Right along that vein. Same thing with this one. Alright, I think the edges with this one. And then on these, I use my gold silk. Remember, you have to shake it. Alright. Never know where this is going to go. And then I use my Cranberry Bliss silk. Shake it good. This one to me seems thicker. All right. Take my bone folder again. And I work with my leaves, making sure that I am not touching the Cranberry Bliss silk because it's still wet. All right. Edges there. Oh, see, I did it. I'm gonna hide that. Watch this. Huh. All right. So there I have my leaves, and to keep them 3D, I flip them over, and I use my small pop dots, put them up the spine of the leaf, all right. And then I think that needs to go about right there. Same thing with this one, right up the spine of the leaf. Okay. This works better when you're silk is dry and you can put it down flat on the paper and peel the backing off. Alright, I think about right there. Alright, and then with your pumpkin spice one, do two here. And then on this third one, I peeled off the backing of the third one, put another one there, because you have one deep here already, so this will make it two, so this one goes off, so it needs to be higher, if that makes sense. All right. Okay, and I'm going to curl this one a little bit, and this one just gets one. And we'll give them two pop dots. Now you see why I go through so many pop dots. Alright, I'm going to put it about there. And then I have my wooden button. And I used my raspberry ink pad again. I love wooden pieces. Oh, wrong one. It's going to be a little darker. I try to keep my sponges from contaminating my ink pads, but it happens sometimes. You kind of have to work it to get it into that crease there. All right. And let me clean off my fingers here before I get in with that twine and stain it all up with different kinds of ink. What do you think so far? All right. Starting from the back, I am going to thread my button up. All right. There we go. All right. I'm going to cut that off. Just like that. And I have my ends down here. I'm going to use my journey twine. Just like that. Actually, I'm going to let this end hang down a little bit more. Alright. So I have two loops on each side. Okay, so I have one, two, one, two. I'm going to lay it here on the back of my button so you can see what I'm doing. I'm tying it there. I'm going to tie it in a knot so it holds my faux bow there. These two come off. Alright, see, I got my little double bow going there. Alright. And I'm going to use dimensional dot because my glue dots are all in another bin for class today. I'm gonna set it right there. Play with my bow a little bit. Oh, come here. All right. Got right there. All right, and then I take my pineapple smoothie crimp ribbon, come in from the back again, can't get it. People ask me why I don't get manicures. Look at my hands. Aren't they awful? Like it'd be a waste of money for me to get it. Money I can spend on new stamp stuff. Alright. And then I just tie it in a knot. Isn't gonna let me move it. It needs to go up just a tad. So there you have it. That's how you make it. Thanks for stopping by. I'll have all the measurements and all of the products that I use listed out on my blog. That's cindyscreativejourney.blogspot.com. Thank you. Bye.